Hello everyone and... Oh, squeaky chair. Hello everyone and welcome back to another episode of the Let's Play series. I'm at Red Leaf Station right now. Hi, History. Hi. And he's just showing off his new exits, which I showed in the last episode actually. But he did a really nice job building it, I'm gonna say that again. Like all these decorations and flower beds and even these little flower pots I really like. Anyway, I'm gonna go towards Narnia Station because today I want to build a really cool station inside the cave. So let's see how that turns out. I'm gonna have to wait for the train here. So in the last episode, I had my wife learn how to drive one of these trains, but I already turned the line back to automatic mode, so you can't drive them right now. History, have you seen Isert Estate Station? Oh, nice. Oh, you're outside now. Have you seen Narnia though? The other station down the line? Okay, so if you want to hop on the next train, I can show you around a bit. But I'm on my way. Oh, Nemo is here. Glad you got your mods updated. There's been a few updates recently. Okay, this is Narnia Station, and I'm gonna wait for the next train because History's on the next train. So I'm gonna... Ooh, I just realized I don't have benches on here. Nemo just teleported. Yeah, I don't have anywhere to sit on the platform. But that's okay. Oh, you're in the front car. Hey! So, what I try to do here, I was trying to do like a winter to spring transition. And the wall is kind of like fading into green from white. I don't know how this effect turned out. I think it could be better. Yeah, you know the books. Anyway, so this one goes up there to... I just flew over the ticket barriers. I hope no one's gonna catch me. Anyway, there's a lot of powdered snow here that you can accidentally fall through if you're not careful. So there's only one exit here for now, but if you guys want to help me build another one, that's fine. So today I wanted to build a station after this one along the line. So I'm gonna switch to spectator mode. I already have night vision. I'm gonna fly past the siding and come out here to this really cool cave. So what I'm thinking of is I'm gonna put the platforms right about here and then try to extend this for another 100 blocks. And then this, if this goes well, this should be 101 blocks. Let's see. Yep. So this is gonna be the correct platform length. Oh, you gave me the night vision with particles. If you use the command, you can give yourself night vision without particles. Let me connect up these tracks real quick so that we can see the train come through here. Yeah, 1.18 caves are really something else. These two stations are gonna be pretty close together, but I guess I don't really mind because this is a pretty cool area. I can't miss this opportunity to build here. I need to somehow get 101 block siding here. So maybe if I can just stuff it here somewhere. Don't try this at home, because this is not a good way to build railways. But this is temporary anyway, so oh well. Is this long enough? Put this right here. How many cars is this? Oh, 4 cars. Perfect. Okay, this is my temporary siding. Don't laugh. Okay, I've set up everything in the depot and the train should now be running. This is, again, temporary for now, so don't laugh at me. Oh, they went the wrong way. That's funny. Okay, I'm gonna use one-way rails to force the trains to go. The trains from the 12th dimension. Okay, let's see. This should fix it, right? Refresh. Okay, fingers crossed this should work now. Oh, there's a bunch of water here. Okay, and gravel. Nice, so we have the platform structure set up. I kind of think we could potentially shift the platform. I guess that's not really necessary at this point, so leave it, I guess. And then set zero. So I think a cool aesthetic might be if, like, we do kind of a lava theme, so the platform is gonna be like melting away to the sides. I think that would be really cool, but also really hard to do. History thinks it would be cool. The lighting would come from the lava, yeah. So what base block should I use? Ancient debris? No. Maybe wax copper? Wood? So like if I do a shape sort of like this, that goes down over the edge. Not sure. So it kind of like flows over the edge. You know what I mean. I don't know. Do you think copper is a good block to build with? I don't know what else to use. Magma maybe? Magma block? But then it'll be painful. Okay, deep slate? Deep slate and magma might be a really good combination. So let's try. I'm gonna try world edit replacing that. Nice. Maybe 90%? So we're gonna need something to sort of cover these so that people don't get hurt in survival. Or maybe just this part can be deep slate. So like the part where people actually stand on would be deep slate. And then the rest of these would be magma with increasing amounts. And so it'll end up like sort of like dripping down like that. I think that'd be a pretty cool effect. What do you think? Yeah. Yeah. Well, if I think if the lava goes all the way down though, it might spread and be messy. I don't know. Or maybe it'll work. Let's try it. Okay. Nice quartz stuff. So are we doing like a a melt-away kind of theme? No, I think that looks good. Don't remove it. That might work for here. And so as the cave gets bigger, it kind of melts over the edge. I don't know. Might be a good option. Anyway, I'm gonna world edit a bit more of this so that there's more magma block here, so maybe 50-50. Yeah, that looks really cool. Nemo, how far do you think I should go with this? Exits. There will be exits to the mineshaft, for sure. And then maybe like one long elevator to the top. Because the cave does come out at ground level here, it just cuts through a few layers of stone. So, wow, there's even an ice spikes kind of cave here. Really cool. Yeah, let's try going. History, do you know how to use world edit to do that? You can do random blocks with world edit. Like that. Yeah, so the command is something like that. So you can do / set 50% stone or 50% grass block, something like that. And then it can do random amounts. Yeah. What do you mean you don't? Yeah, the numbers don't have to add up to 100, but It's just conceptually easier to understand. So I guess technically you can do like 1% and 5%. That works too. So I'm gonna set 50% magma lock and 50% air. Okay, that looks a bit weird. And then it filled the holes. Okay, that makes sense. So you can just assume default is 1. How does that look? Maybe a bit more deep slate. Yeah, I need some lava. You can put some lava. I think the white kind of looks... I don't know. Does that fit with the theme? Maybe we could use a different dark block as well. That might work. So like, let's see. Polished deep slate? Oh, what'd you use? Deep slate. Are they just different? Wait. Never mind. Ignore me. Cold blocks, maybe? I don't know, maybe not. And if I remember correctly, deep slate has different block states, right? They have different axes. Yeah. So if we put it in the wrong axis, it'll look different. Or we can just randomize it as well. Ooh, I like the look of this. Maybe at the top here, we can do some... Let me try something. Deep slate. 50%. Are you sleeping? Too much diamond, right? Too much diamond. Wait, where are the trains? I think I forgot to do unlimited trains. That's why there's only 1. Yeah, ores might look messy. Platform gates? Nice. Is it 4 blocks? I think it's 4 blocks. I like the slabs. That's a really good addition. Bit more texture like this. We don't need to follow the curve with the escalators. It can just be like a drop-off. I think that would look good. So like, without these blocks. What should I name the station? You guys have any ideas? Do we need a ceiling? Whoa, underground. I see that. No, it's cool. You can keep the trains running with the underground. I don't really mind. It's just testing for now. Wait, do we want the escalator to be like flat like this? Is that gonna look a bit weird? You put barriers as well. Interesting. Barriers are useful. Yeah, nice. History, I think if the escalator just connected, it might be easier. No, it's off. No. There's still a bunch of commands that I don't use, but thanks for the compliment. Sometimes escalators are really just easier to build manually. That's just the way it is. Alright, escalators are in. We could probably build some sort of concourse down here. I want to see what it looks like without night vision. Wow, this looks really cool without night vision. Nice job on the build. Like, nice job on putting the lava and stuff. I think after adding some ceiling lights, this would look really good. So are you thinking just having escalators on one side, or maybe down the middle as well? So that's a logical place to put escalators. Yeah, well, to get to the other platforms, you can just come down the escalator, walk over to the other side, because technically this part of this cave will be part of the station area. So you would come down that escalator, walk over, and then go up the escalator to this side. So we are gonna need to copy this whole thing over to the other side if you guys don't mind. And the lava patterns are gonna be the same, but oh well, easier. So, oh, nice. I like that. Okay, so some of the lava didn't get copied over, so history, you might have to manually do that. But most of the stuff got copied, so that's nice. I'm gonna need to set the floor level to also the deep slate stuff. Wait. Yeah, okay. This should be equal. If you guys want to make a line interchanging here, that'd be totally cool as well. There was a roller coaster mod in like 1.7 or something. I've never really played it myself, but I got a lot of ideas from it. Yeah. Sandtown is one big roller coaster. No, I think Sandtown's gotten better. But some of the older builds are still very much roller coaster like. Okay, I pasted the automatic platform gates, and these escalators now come down here. I'm gonna make a proper concourse area here, so there'll be two sides. Maybe I'll raise the escalators like one block higher. And it's kind of hard to see because the train's in the way. What should I set as the floor block? Wait, Nemo, what are you talking about? Oh, the walls. We don't want people stepping on the magma blocks. Wait, who built this bridge for the siding? It's just temporary. But it does look like a cool bridge for people to walk over though, so nice. Yeah, the floor is literally lava. Hmm? Let's see what you're up to. Wow! Spiral line? Nice. So you need a way for the train to get back to the siding somehow. You can only have one siding for the line. So that end, I'll just do an example for you. So if the train starts from that siding down there, the train will go up, 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 and then down to that platform. Yeah, and then it's gonna need to come back here. You keep saying you don't know how to do this stuff, but it seems like you secretly know. By the way, Nemo, if you want to come over here and take a look at these wheels for these mini trains, I think this needs to be fixed. I don't think we accounted for this edge case, but that's okay. It still works perfectly fine. It just looks funny. Yay! Does it go faster and faster as it goes up? Oh, it doesn't stop at the platforms. It just keeps going. Go, go, go! Faster, faster, faster! And we drop and stop. Nice. Maybe we can make this a tourist attraction. Tourist attraction at Eistert Estate. Nice work. Oh, where'd the train go? Did you adjust settings? Oh no, did you delete Eistert Estate Station? Oh, this is max acceleration. Whee! Oh, it slows down and then it goes back up. Whoa, that was dizzying. I think we need to add back the station though, or else it'll become untitled. Okay, I'm gonna go back to the cave. It's to continue to work on that station. Okay, I think I'm gonna name this station Yanjiang Mineshaft. Ooh, I like the lava under the glass panes. That's a really nice addition. And I'll make the station color some sort of complementing tone, I think. I don't know. Trying to choose a color that might complement the lava's color scheme. Green? No, I think just going with orange should be best. Oh, this might work. Like that might work. This hole, literally people can fall through. But, so we might need like glass thingies. Like that. How do you like the look of the fence and stuff? Do you think that's good? I'm gonna build an escalator all the way down to the bottom where the skulk is. Oh wait, there's another level for the mineshaft here, so maybe I should stop the escalator here first. Okay, so the first exit for the station, I am going to make it right here for the mineshaft itself. And I'm gonna add that to the station exits in the dashboard actually. So A1, and then I'm gonna add an exit destination with the name of the mineshaft. Press done and then grab myself a sign. Hopefully that would show up properly. I think I'm gonna put it right at the end maybe. So exit. Oh, my station area is not big enough. Let me redraw that. So exit A would be the mineshaft. Okay, cool. I think maybe a smaller sign would do. That looks like 4 blocks, maybe? No, that's a bit squished. Cool. And then this side would be to trains. I like using the London Underground crossbar. Even though it might not be intended for this purpose, but it looks good with signs like this. And then the LU pull goes well with that. And then maybe an entrance sign. Floating white text. Maybe I should put something behind it, like deep slate. That works. So this escalator will go to that mineshaft. And then maybe a branch to go down to this level. So maybe I would make the escalators. Nice, wow, Dragon's a fast builder. Last stop already. Whoa, what was that explosion? I heard an explosion. Is that part of the biome? Well, we need to make a station exit here anyway. Explosions won't stop people from riding the train. Whoa! Do the skulk sensors send stuff? It detects sound and it makes something explode? I don't know. For some reason regeneration is so slow with World Edit. So I'm gonna make an A2 exit right here, and it's gonna be A2 with the destination of Blue Cave, I guess. Not very creative. Oh, history was AFK. Welcome back. Not very creative with my naming, but good enough, I think. Blue Fire Cave. Well, updates, I built exits to the station, at least cave exits. And Nemo made a lot of good progress as well with the platform, I think. So good job on that. A1. And A2 will be down there. Cool. Too bad the crossbar can't go in both directions. But I think I'm gonna make a pillar right there. Alright, so this little lobby here has some signs now. This one points to A1. This points to A2 down the escalators, and this goes up to the trains. I think I'm gonna move these signs over a little bit, just so that it's more equal, because there's like 3 blocks here and there's 6 blocks here. So if I cut and paste, that looks better, I think. Yep, perfect. This is a really cool ambiance. Oh, history, what are you building? Oh, I mean, I was fine with it floating, or you can use chains and stuff. Yeah, chains. Chains would be a good idea. Or the chains can go all the way up to the top as well, but it's okay. I'd be interested to see what you want to do with it. Because I feel like if there's like a block of stuff just covering the view, I don't know. We'll see. Oh, okay. If you can naturalize it, that would look good. Nice. And let me just fence off this area. Wow, I really like what you've done here in the middle. Looks really good. Nice. Really impressed. Kind of thinking where to put ticket barriers, because there's not much space here. People, you might have to, like, force people to, like, walk this way. Go to the ticket machines here. Oh! I haven't considered that. Is there a game rule to turn off, like, burning? Yeah, might be better to replace it. I do have to go soon. So I think I might just wrap it up here and then decorate the concourse a little bit more later. Let's take a look at Dragon's First Train. Wow, nice. Nice design. And this goes to spawn, okay. Next station is Birch Valley. I like how you use the big roundels. The Elizabeth Line colors. Spawn and coast, nice. Oh, the door closing sounds are probably from the resource pack, right?
Next station, Birch Valley.
Oh, there's this turn that goes on the left. I wonder what's over there. The siding, maybe? Okay, Forest Peaks is next. Wow, nice deep slate again. Looks pretty cool underneath. Oh, and you got an elevator there. That's good. And then... this is all single-tracked as well, which is pretty impressive. Because you have to signal the trains properly.
Next station, Three Rivers.
Three Rivers. And this is the chiseled stone bricks with some outdoor sections. I like the design of how it's like cutting into the mountain. Yeah, and it's hard to make, and there's probably a bypass here. And this is the really steep incline up and over to spawn.
乘客可以轉乘重生線、蘇鐵線、南台索道、雪地特快。 Next station, Spung. Interchange station for the Spung line.
And there we are.
Zion Heights Ropeway, Snowland Express.
Nice work, Dragon. You can feel free to build more lines as well. Like more on the east side. Yeah. Okay, anyway, that's all the time I have for today. I'm pretty hungry. It's time for dinner for me. Thank you everyone for watching. I think we made really good progress on the mineshaft station. Thanks Nemo, History, Dragon for participating. Alright, I'll see you in the next episode. Make sure to subscribe and leave a comment if you liked it.